I'm John. I'm the negotiator, and I know junk.
$100, man.
I'll hold you.
This is my brother, Jimmy. Jimmy's our creative genius who transforms trash into cash.
I think I'm the king of the world. I made it.
That's my son, Matthew, a.k.a. Rat Boy. He doesn't talk much, but he's a hard worker and a good kid.
Good job, Rat Boy.
We put it all on the line each weekend at flea markets all over New York City.
Living the dream. I'm a flea market vendor.
Every negotiation I make can mean the difference between going broke...
$100.
Wow!
...or big profits.
It's a good day's pay.
Welcome to Dirty Money.
What's the story with this base? Is this yours? Looks like someone was using it as a sledgehammer.
What are you going to do with this? Let me ask you. Can we turn a profit?
Yeah, well, I'll turn it into something.
Really?
Yeah.
What brand is it?
It's a Fender.
It's a Fender.
Sven's got this bass. It's the Mexican precision bass, which is not as expensive as the American-made one, so I know it's affordable. I've made custom guitars in the past. This is a perfect starting point for me, and I think we can get a good deal. What are you asking?
$200.
$25.
My tactic with Sven is a little bit different. Usually I'm the nice guy, but with him, I just try to annoy him.
Why would I sell it to you for $25? I can sell it to somebody else for $150.
Because I would pay for it right now, and then someone else doesn't exist yet till someone else comes in.
$50, fine. That's as low as I can go on that, $50, if you're getting the rest of that stuff.
$25.
No, I can't go lower than $50.
You know what? I'll put in the extra $25.
I'm not crazy about this bass guitar. It's $50, it's beat up. It's something that you can see at any garage sale, so Jimmy's really gonna have to do his magic if we're gonna make any money at our flea market spot this coming weekend. You know what, after a long day of hunting and dumpster diving, we like to come back to the shop. It's underground, in New York City, it smells, it has no windows, and it's infested with rats. This shop is our home, but this is where all the magic happens with Jimmy DiResta's genius.
This is where we turn trash into treasure.
Who do you think got more chicks, the lead guitarist or the bassist?
Of course, the lead guitarist. Why would you even ask that question?
Maybe you heard of a little someone by the name of Gene Simmons. 4,000 women. And actually, that's 4,000 more women than Rat Boy's gotten. He's a 21-year-old virgin.
John's going on and on about Gene Simmons. And Gene Simmons used to use a bass guitar that was an axe. And right there it hit me. I'm looking at the saw blade on the wall. Instead of making it the axe, I'm gonna do one better. We'll make it a buzzsaw.
Oh, like a saw blade.
Anybody can go online and buy the Gene Simmons bass, but nobody's gonna be able to find this bass that I created unless they come to my flea market spot. A day or two's worth of work, I'm gonna be able to turn this into tremendous profit. And what we'll do is we'll start by taking this apart, loosening the strings.
Okay. Okay, what's under there?
That's the ground.
That sends the sound?
The strings vibrate over the magnetic field, and that's what makes the sound go.
I have no idea how a bass guitar works.
That's it, no glue? That thing just comes apart?
Then again, I don't know how a plane flies.
One of the first things I'm gonna do is cut the two curved sides off of this bass. That's to give me a nice flat joint. Hard vehicle.
Okay.
Should make the thickness of our body. The next thing I'm gonna do is add some more wood on the flat sides. This will give me enough surface area to create my new design. Next, I'm gonna sketch out the pattern for the new design on tracing paper so I can cut out the buzzsaw shape.
We got our pattern in place. I'm gonna cut it out on the bandsaw.
All right. Well, be careful.
All right, watch this.
You only have one good pinky left. Jimmy cut his pinky off 1 year ago today, and if you could see, they put it on crooked because he had bad insurance. It looks like you have two thumbs, like you're some kind of missing link. It looks like a shrimp in an all-you-can-eat buffet.
Yeah, I put it in cocktail sauce and I lick it off every night.
I do the same thing.
Boy, that came out nice.
Like that?
Yeah, that looks like a saw blade.
I originally paid $50 for this thing, but now I think I can get $500 for it at the flea market.
I have to admit, up front, I was a doubting Thomas about the bass guitar, but at the end of the day, he made a fantastic, cool buzzsaw bass. I wish I knew how to play bass and was in a band. I wish I was Gene Simmons.
Looks like the banjo from hell.
It does, doesn't it? It's awesome.
Yeah. We paid $50, and what do you want to sell it for?
The Gene Simmons axe, if you had to buy it, is about $700.
All right, let's start at $499. People like to hear that.
$499, and we'll see where we go.
What's the brand name?
It's a Fender.
It's customized, right?
It's a customized Fender. Come take a look.
We'll make a deal. Come on
in. We'll give you a deal.
We finally got one on the hook.
It's funny because we're thinking that somebody, heavy metal head, somebody with long hair is going to come along, and then her family comes along.
Sure.
And the kid wants it. The kid, when he's 15 years old.
Yep.
Is this your mom?
She's a single mom. She wants to buy the kid a little souvenir from New York. What's better than a handmade Gene Simmons-inspired bass guitar?
You have a tongue like Gene Simmons, don't you?
I do.
Let's see. It's disgusting.
We'll do it for $275.
I wanted $499 for this guitar. We went down a little bit here and there, but you just like immediately spit a number out that was half the price nearly.
I'm sorry.
I'll go $225.
$225?
$225.
Do you realize when you tell somebody a number, you can't add up? You can't say, oh, I meant to say. You know you can't do that?
I know that. Do you realize it was late in the day and I can't eat a bass guitar?
$225. You got a deal. We like Canada. There you go. Congratulations, my friend. Hey, we're going to see that on TV when you become famous.
All right.
Yeah.
We were down at the other end of the flea market. He says, Mom, come take a look at this guitar.
Yeah. Custom guitar makers, they usually charge like $20,000, $100,000, stuff like that. But this, you know, I think it's a steal that we got at this price. I've never seen a guitar like this ever, actually.
The guitar is going to go to a nice home.
I'm happy that kid was appreciative of it. He really understood what we did, and the mother was extremely happy to please the kid.